Here's how to manage your calendar surface in the new Outlook. Open the new Outlook for Windows. Select the calendar icon from the app bar on the left side of the screen. Choose from Day, Work Week, Week, and Month views to show the desired number of days in your calendar surface. Customize your working days in calendar settings to ensure your 5-day work week view is accurate. There are several other customizations available to you, such as adding up to 21 time zones, changing the time scale, and using dynamic column widths to expand the current day on the calendar surface. When you have more than one calendar selected, you can view them separately in split view, or as one calendar in a combined view. Select the split view button to view the calendars side by side, or unselect it to see the calendar events in one combined view. When new events are sent to you, they will appear on your calendar surface as tentative until you send an RSVP to the organizer. Right-click on your unresponded events to accept, decline, or mark your status as tentative, or you can propose a new time if needed. For a recurring series, you can select an RSVP option for either a single instance of that series or the entire series. If you're unable to attend a meeting, you can select Follow as your response to help you stay informed of the meeting events. The Follow option will be available if a meeting has two or more participants and when the organizer has requested responses. Following a meeting will mark that event status as free on your calendar. Add categories to your events to help you organize meetings and appointments. To access the categories menu, right-click an event on the calendar surface and select Categorize. When you add a category to an event series, it will show up on all instances. You can also edit categories from the Outlook settings menu under Accounts and Categories. You can also add a category to an event when it comes into your inbox. To access the Categories menu, right-click an event in your inbox and select Categorize. Filters can be used to remove or show select items on your calendar surface. You enable filters based on things like category, RSVP status, meeting location, free busy state, and more. When a filter is applied, the button label will change to Filters Applied. To clear filters, select the Clear Filters option within the Filters drop-down menu, and all items in the menu will be re-enabled. Choose whether to keep or delete event invitations from your inbox, even after you've sent an RSVP to the organizer. To do this, from the Calendar Settings menu, under Events and Invitations, select Delete Invitations from Inbox after responding. To disable the feature, unselect the checkbox in the same location. You can choose to automatically send a decline RSVP for incoming meetings when there is an existing conflict in that meeting slot. To enable this feature, select Automatically Decline Invitations that conflict with existing events from the Calendar Settings menu. To disable the feature, unselect the checkbox in the same location. Additionally, you can choose to automatically keep meetings on your calendar, even after you've sent a decline RSVP. Your schedule will appear as free to others during this time slot, but the event will stay visible to you. This allows you to keep track of meetings you may be interested in, but are unable to attend. To enable this feature, select Show Declined Events on your calendar from the Calendar Settings menu. To disable the feature and remove declined meetings from your calendar, unselect the checkbox in the same location.